Hi, today I'll be sharing with you how you can add a calculated field in Data Studio to group your data using case function. On the left-hand side, we have a pie chart that shows us total sales by each product. However, the problem is that by looking at this chart, it is difficult to know which product line, for instance, stationery, tech gadgets, or monitor has the best performance. So we will need to label the category of the products in order to visualize that, which is shown on the right-hand side. To do this, we can create a calculated field based on product name using case function. So first thing, I will just click on the chart and go to the most bottom and click on add a field. So here, I'm going to paste the statement that I just written. What I have written is just a brief logic statement. When the product name is wireless, mouse, trackpad, monitor arm, then I will want to call the category as tech gadget, and so on. After you have constructed the logic, now it's time to modify it to make sure all the syntax is correct. First, always start with a case clause and end with an and clause. Then, you need to know which operator you need to use for the condition statement. For example, we use equal sign to evaluate single value, and we use in operator for multiple values. Now let's modify the case formula accordingly. First, I'm changing is to equal sign, and then you need to make sure all the strings are surrounded with quotes. Here, I'm using the approach of writing out the logic first, then only we write it in a proper syntax. The reason because I think it is less overwhelming if we do it step by step, like we tackle one small problem at one point of time. Of course, if you are familiar with the formulas already, I mean the syntax already, then you don't have to do this. You can just straight away write it in the proper format. But here, I just want to show you what is the steps if you are not very familiar of how to write this. Okay, now we are adding in the brackets after the in operator. Oh, I'm going to do it the same for this one. Alright, the last step, I'm going to give this a name. So after that, you can click save and click finished. Here you will need to refresh the whole browser in order to have access to the new field. Then you can drag in the new category and replace the dimension. Lastly, we have else statement. It is optional to define else statement, so you can choose not to add in. But here, I just want to highlight to you that if we don't add in the else statement, whenever there's new product added, which we didn't define it previously in the condition, it will become a blank value. So let me show you an example. First, we go to the data source and then we add one more transaction at the bottom. Then we refresh the data. And you can see now, in the pie chart, there's one category without any labels. So it can be quite confusing to the user if it's showing as a blank. Let's say we add the else statement. So the value new product would be the default value if none of the when condition above is true. After that, just click refresh data to get rid of all the errors. And whenever there's new product that is not being categorized, it will be shown as new product in the pie chart. So in that case, we can go to the formula and add in the new product name into an appropriate category. Just add in book into the stationery group and click finished. Now we have successfully labeled all of our products with its category name. So that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll put the reference to the case formula from Google Data Studio in the description. Make sure you check it out if you want to understand more examples on how to use this.